In this lecture, we will try to solve a numerical so that we can further understand the concept of the ABCD parameters or the equivalent circuit model of a transmission line. Now, let's see what's the question. We are given that there is a 3-phase 50 hertz transmission line whose length is 400 km and various parameters, that is resistance per phase per unit length of the line, is 0.125 ohm per kilometer. The reactance or the inductance part is 0.4 ohm per kilometer per phase, and the shunt admittance is 2.8 into 10 to the power minus 6 mho per kilometer. We are also given that the sending end voltage is at 220 kV level and the receiving end voltage cannot exceed 250 kV. It should be less than or equal to 250 kV. Now, what we need to find? We need to find the maximum possible operating frequency of the transmission line. So, let's see how to solve this. Before proceeding further, let us find the total parameters of the line. The total resistance will be resistance per unit length into the length of the line, which is simply 0.125 into 400 is equal to 50 ohm. Similarly, the X reactance will be 160 ohm. Shunt admittance will be 1.12 into 10 to the power minus 3 mho. Now, these two values depend upon the frequency, and this resistance is independent of the frequency. Okay. We are going to use the equivalent pi model. Okay. For that, we know that A is given by simply 1 plus YZ by 2. Now, before going on further, we should know that Y and Z will change with frequency. So, if these are given at 50 Hertz, we should know their value, what will be their value at the new frequency. We know that Y or Z are proportional to the frequency. So, I can say that Y at F max over Y at 50 Hertz is simply equal to F max over 50. Let me write this as Y nu only. So, Y nu or Y at F max is equal to Y at 50 Hertz into F max over 50. Similarly, Z nu can be written as Z at 50 into F max over 50. So, instead of using Y or Z, we will use Y nu and Z nu in the formula. Now, what is the value of A? We know that Vs, the sending end voltage, can be written as AVR plus BIR. Now, we know that the worst case scenario will be possible when the Ferranti effect will be highest. When it will be highest? It will be highest when there will be no load. That is, the receiving end current is equal to zero. So, it implies Vs will be equal to AVR, or A is simply Vs over VR, and its magnitude is simply the ratio of the magnitudes. By putting the values, what I will get? I will get the magnitude of A is equal to 0.88. Now, putting this in the formula, I will get 0.88 should be equal to the magnitude of 1 plus Y nu Z nu over 2. Putting these values, what I will get? I will simply get 1 plus, what is Y nu? Y nu is simply Y at 50. What it was? J 1.12 into 10 to the power minus 3 into F max over 50. What will be Z nu? Z nu will be simply Z at 50 into F max by 50. Now, in the impedance part, resistance will not depend upon the frequency, so it will remain same. And the reactance part will change and it will become J160 into F max over 50. Now solving it further, what I will get? 0.88 equals to 1 plus J1.12 into 10 is to the power minus 3 into F max into 50 over 50, and J into J is equal to minus 1, that is J square is minus 1. It will become 1.12 into 10 is to the power minus 3 into F max squared over 50 squared. Now I can simplify it further just by seeing that this part, the imaginary part, is very small as compared to the real part. I missed 160 here. This 160 should be in the multiplication also. So you see, this imaginary part is very small or negligible as compared to the real parts. So I will neglect this part. So what I will get? I will get 0.88 should be equal to 1 minus 1.12 into 10 to the power minus 3 into 160 into F max squared over 50 squared. Okay. Now on solving it further, I already solved this. I will get the value of F max, and it came out to be 57.9 hertz. Okay. So here we have seen that the transmission line also have a maximum limit for the frequency of operation. We have also seen that the value of A can either be equal to or less than 1 only, because it also shows that there will be a Ferranti effect on the line. So for short line, A is equal to 1, and for medium length line or the long lines, A is usually less than 1 to show the effect of Ferranti effect. In the next video, we will try to solve one numerical on reactive power compensation also. If you find this lecture is helpful to you, then please share and subscribe our YouTube channel. Thank you.